Hey guys, it's Lizzie here. Today I'm going to show you how to create this Harley Quinn inspired makeup look from the film that's coming out next August called Suicide Squad. So for this particular look, we used eyeshadows from the BH Cosmetic palette, and then for the hair we applied some hair chalks to damp hair, and that washes out immediately, so it's a great way for you to temporary dye your hair for these sorts of looks. So if you want to know how to recreate it, then just keep watching. Thank you. So firstly I'm going to take a dark turquoise eyeshadow and just run that across the mobile lid. You want it to match the hair colour as closely as possible. You just need a wash of colour. It doesn't have to be too neat. And then wing it out a little bit at the side, but don't make any sort of definite shapes with the colour. I'm just going to run that colour under the eye, again, quite messily. And wing the makeup up and out the outer corner. Now with a black eyeshadow, you just want to darken the lash line, just a little bit, run that all the way across. And I'm using a fluffy brush for this so that the colour isn't put on the skin too dramatically, and it will also mean that I can blend it out as I go along. As we've already done the foundation, you want to make sure that you tap off your brush in between each time of applying the makeup so you don't get any fallout onto your cheeks. Then we're going to go back to the first brush and just blend in some more blue over the top, just so you get a nicer fade from the black to the blue. I'm then taking the black eyeshadow on a definer brush, I'm just going to run that really close to the lashes under the eye. Again, make sure to tap off the excess. Just make sure that you've joined it up on the outer corner. We're just going to take our first brush and blend out that black a little bit more, with a tiny bit of the blue on. Now I'm just going to take Urban Decay's Glide On 24/7 Pencil in Perversion and just run that along the top lash line, just to deepen up the area and just to make sure that there's no bits of skin peeking through. We will be blending this out, so make sure that you use a soft enough pencil, one that doesn't set too quickly. Now we're going to do the red side, so I'm just taking a bright primary red all over the lid. I haven't set the foundation yet, because as you can see, I rest my hands on Imogen's skin, so it's rubbing off the foundation as we go. We'll set that right at the end when we finish the eye makeup, and then we'll do the sweeps of colour on the cheeks as well. We're just going to take that red eyeshadow right close under the eye. And we're just going to take the smaller fluffy brush that we put the black on with and run that close to the lash line. And again, when there's less on the brush, just blend it up and out in the outer corner and blend it into the red. So with our first brush, with the red on, we're just going to reapply that over the area, soften the black a bit and blend the colour up and out. Then we'll just take the black under the lash line as well, all the way to the two left. And with our red brush, just blend that out. Just to get rid of any fallout, we're just going to go under the eyes with some concealer and blend that in with our foundation brush. We're just going to set the skin with a translucent powder, and for this I'm using one by Kryolan, but you can use any translucent powder that you've got, or skin tone powder if you want a more fuller coverage. Her skin is quite pale, so I have added a bit of a lighter foundation onto Imogen's usual foundation colour, just to lighten up her skin a bit. Now for the brows, I'll be using L'Oreal Brow Artist Plumper in the medium dark shade. So for mascara today, I'll be using Rimmel Scandalized Mascara, and I'll be doing that off camera, and then I'll be right back. Next, we're going to do the smears of colour down the cheeks. So I'm just taking a bigger brush and with some of the red, and then you can keep your eyes closed if you like. You just want to run the brush quite messily across the skin in a straight line. The kind of quicker and swifter the movement, the more natural it's going to look. So I'm just going to go back over that to deepen the colour, and then just do the same with the blue side as well. And for the lips, I'll be using a lipstick by Bourjois. It's a limited edition number 13 jet set. I'll be using a lip brush for that, and I'm just going to draw on the colour. So off camera, I also did her two tattoos. So for the love heart, I used an eyeliner by Collection, and then for the word rotten across her jaw, I used Kat Von D's tattoo eyeliner in Troops. So there we go guys, that's the makeup look complete. So as you can see, it's a relatively simple makeup look using products that you most probably have at home or you can get quite easily. So thank you so much for watching and look forward to seeing you again soon. Take care, bye bye.